I want to give you a personal testimony of a savage storm that I went through. I have debated for months whether to tell this personal story of crisis to my church and the national television audience. And until today, it has been top secret in this ministry.
Food alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
Almighty God, look down upon this thy house, and we thy humble servants. Grant us the spirit of thy grace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Who has done this? Answer me, who has done this?
An edict, squire, from the Archbishop himself, and by order of the king.
By order of the king? Is the Church of England not a Protestant church? Would the king turn the house of God into a Roman temple?
Mr. Cromwell, I beseech you.
Does the king think that God can be bought with gold, trinkets, and gilded rubbish?
I know only that I have been instructed.
Has this king forgotten the Reformation?
Mr. Cromwell,
away with this popish idolatry! Did the Lord not say unto Moses, thou shalt not make unto thyself any graven image? Now bow down to them!
I want to give you a personal testimony of a savage storm that I went through. I have debated for months whether to tell this personal story of crisis to my church and the national television audience. And until today, it has been top secret in this ministry.
Man doesn't live by bread alone, natural food alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God. Faith.
Now to the congregation. As solemn vows are about to be made before you and baptism is now to be administered, you who are baptized will do well to take this occasion to reflect on your own baptism. Christ has put his name and claim on you. He calls you to be repentant for your sins against your covenant God, to confess your faith before men, and to live in newness of life to God who sealed his covenant with you by the blood of his own Son. As the parents, we have questions affirming your commitment to raising all of your children in the Lord. First, do you acknowledge that although our children are conceived and born in sin and therefore are subject to condemnation, they are holy in Christ by virtue of the covenant of grace, and as children of the covenant are to be baptized? Praise God. Do you promise to teach diligently to Judah the principles of our holy Christian faith revealed in the scriptures of the Old and New Testaments and summarized in the Confession of Faith and catechisms of this church? Praise God. Do you promise to pray regularly with and for Judah and to set an example of piety and godliness before him? Praise God. And do you promise to endeavor by all the means that God has appointed to bring Judah up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord, encouraging him to appropriate for himself the blessings and fulfill the obligations of the covenant? Judah brought, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, and in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Spirit. Praise God.
Oh, here is something to glory in. God forbid that I should glory, save in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ. God forbid that I should glory, save in the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus, my Lord. God forbid the Free Presbyterian Church should ever glory in anything else. You can take your fine buildings. You can take your congregations. You can take everything that would attract the natural man to the movement. Forget about it. There's only one thing that counts: the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus, our Lord. The world.
That's what Luther came to terms with when he discovered that the just shall live by faith. Despite what Rome had taught him, despite even what his own heart had taught him, he knew he had to obey God rather than the traditions of the Roman Catholic Church. He knew he had to obey God rather than himself. Luther had tried. Luther had strived with all of his being to achieve his own salvation, even resorting to self-inflicted punishment to try to do penance for his sins. He wanted to do it all himself. But what did the text say? The just shall live by faith. And though this went against his natural inclinations as a fallen son of Adam, God enabled Luther by his grace to divert all of his trust away from himself and to put all of his trust in Christ. And by the end of that, all Luther could say was this: my conscience is held captive by the word of God, for to go against conscience is neither right nor safe. Here I stand. I can do no other. God help me.
This is my body given for you. Take this and eat it, and do it in remembrance of me. And in that meal where there was many prayers said and cups of wine were taken, at some point in the meal, Jesus paused, raised the glass, and said, this cup is the cup of the new covenant, sealed in my blood, given for the forgiveness of the world's sins. All of you take this cup and drink from it.
Confession of sin. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you made all things, and you call everyone to account. With shame we admit that we have sinned against you in what we have thought, said, and done. And we deserve your judgment. We turn from our sins and are truly sorry for them. Have mercy on us, most merciful Father. Because of the cross of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, forgive us. Enable us by the Spirit to serve and please you in new life. To your honor and glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
And the assurance of pardon, 1 John chapter 4, verses 9 through 10.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the glory forever. Amen.
Together, as brethren in the Lord, in the faith that we share with the Church Catholic, so dear brothers and sisters, what do you believe? We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, begotten from the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of the same essence as the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven. He became incarnate by the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and was made human. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. The third day he rose again according to the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will never end. And we believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life. He proceeds from the Father and the Son, and with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified. He spoke through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We affirm one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look forward to the resurrection of the dead, to life in the world to come. this time let's stand together again. Sing God's word back to him, this time from Psalm 110. It is to the tune of "This Is My Father's World," so I trust it will be familiar to us. A psalm which reminds us so much of the King.